以木乃伊作为题材的影视剧集有很多，但是在美国宾夕法尼亚州就有一具真实的百年无名氏木乃伊。凭着现代先进的技术，人们已经找到了他的真实身份，并会在10月7号举行一场体面的告别仪式，送别这个文化遗产。
人死虽然不能复生，但通过殡葬仪式也算是让亡者安息、告别世界的一种方式。不过，在美国宾夕法尼亚州雷丁小城的一家殡仪馆内，竟然存放着一具超过百年的木乃伊，至今没有入土为安。而这个故事还得追溯回19世纪末。1895年11月19号，一名被警方逮捕的小偷因为肾衰竭死于当地监狱，但由于小偷没有真实姓名，身份无法进行确认，一直无法寻获他的亲属。这些年来，当局只能以斯通曼威利作为他的代号。威利的遗体过后被送往殡仪馆，当时的馆长奥曼正好引进了新的防腐技术，就以这具尸体作为实验对象，把它制成了木乃伊。
Long story short, multiple efforts were taken at trying to identify his real family. It never happened. So as time went on, as months turned into years, pressure was put on Mr. Ahman to bury him. And in historical records, the state kind of demanded he do so. And Mr. Ahman petitioned the state to maintain Willie here because he wanted to, quote unquote, monitor his experiment to see how long indeed this person would remain in a preserved state.
在木乃伊威利寄居殡仪馆的百年内，当地人以各种方式将威利的故事代代相传，所以无论是殡仪馆的员工还是村民，都对他有着特别的浓厚情感。随着时代变迁，殡仪馆也走过了百年岁月，如今更借助现代科技，再根据历史文献进行搜索，终于确定了威利的真实身份。这项消息一出，瞬间牵动了当地人的情绪。居民在10月1号庆祝雷丁市成立275周年时，也以摩托灵车载着威利的灵柩加入游行的队伍。
I always knew about Stone Man Willie. I've never seen him, but my parents, who would have been like 96 and 103 right now, years ago have always told me about Stone Man Willie. I knew he was down at Allman's funeral home, and I read in the paper or online that they were going to have like a proper funeral for him, and I heard the music and great. And I think it's just so cool that they're finally putting him to rest.
And you used the word man. I'm very, very particular about that in my eulogy. He was a man, and he was not stone. His name was not Willie, but he became a legend, which is fine. I'm very much into legends, but he was a man. He had a mother and a father, friends and relatives we know nothing about. And I think that's the important thing for the eulogy of what we know as Stone Man Willie.
威利的身份获得确认后，奥曼殡仪馆决定在10月7号为他举行告别式，与当地居民一同陪着威利走完最后一程，而他的真实姓名将在安葬之后永刻墓碑之上。马新社电视综合报道。